Hello, I'm Martha High, and I'm from Victoria, Virginia, in the United States. And I'm saying hello to World Groove.
Yes, she is. A young lady say you don't love me if you don't respect me. Back for a return visit with a brand new smash. And she answers to the name of the lovely Miss Martha High. Hit it!
You know, I don't want to get rid of the shadow of Mr. Brown because that's where I really feel that's where my professional career started, when I really started traveling with him, because it was totally different than what I was used to. It was on another level. And I started learning more about the business and performing, you know, to entertain. So. But after I left Mr. Brown and I joined Maceo Parker, well, that's when I was able to say, you know, like spread my wings, because I had more freedom to start thinking about myself and thinking about what I want to do, where I want to go. And I decided that I wanted to go as a solo artist. So Maceo gave me that chance to pursue that, because I didn't have the freedom when I was with Mr. Brown, because I wasn't only his, I wasn't just his background singer, I was also his hairstylist. So I was with him like almost 24/7, you know. I had to do his hair in the mornings and the afternoons and the evenings when we were traveling on the road. And even when we were off the road, I ended up moving to Augusta, Georgia, and I did his hair a lot of times when we were off, when we wasn't working. So, and it was all about James Brown, you know, it was all about him all the time. So I really never had the chance to kind of think about whether I wanted to be a solo artist. Yes, he suggested that I should become Martha High because he couldn't, he could pronounce my name, but he always told me,
that's not a name for the stage. I think you should have a better name than that. And I'm going to think about it. So he thought about it and he came up with the name High.
And I've been Martha High ever since. As far as his women are concerned, it sounded as if, or it sounds like people might have think that he was an abuser to every woman or the women that was on his show or that worked with him or something like that. No, he wasn't. I think that he had complications with the women that he was involved with, you know, and what his reasons were, I don't know, you know, but. As far as him abusing women per se, no. Well, starting in the 90s, I started actually performing and working with Bobby Bird. Bobby Bird had his own show, and I had went out on the road with him a couple of times. The first time I went out with him was with Marva Whitney, Lynn Collins, Vicki Anderson, and Vicki Anderson's daughter, Carlene Anderson. And it was really, really a wonderful tour. And it was Bobby Bird and the JB All-Stars. So it was including Maceo Parker, Fred Wesley, Pee Wee Ellis in the band, you know. So it was, that was a great tour. I think things happen in its own time, you know. I'm not trying to make up for being a background singer, because I'm really happy that I started out as a background singer. And I also call myself a connoisseur when it comes to background, because I learned a lot. I learned to be able to sing with other people and to carry harmonies. I think that's helping my solo career. I think it's a boost. I have sang with female artists that were solo artists, was lead singers, and they have a hard time with background, with harmony, you know. And I usually end up teaching them the harmonies, you know, the harmony parts, because it's hard for them to kind of capture that togetherness and to sing with other people. So.
This low-down life is getting to me, pulling on my head, don't see right through me. Whole rotten thing is on my mind, wearing me down, using up my time. Why don't you step back and set me free? 'Cause you can't love me if you don't respect me.
I am so happy. I am so happy. I'm thrilled to be here. And you know what? I another reason why I like it here, I've been here for almost 3 months now, and I have felt good about the where I live, the people around me, the wonderful people that have helped me to move here. I don't see any color, and I don't think the people here have a problem with color. And that's why I'm very, very comfortable in living here and wanting to learn the language. You know, I'm very open when it comes to music. So I like that. I was very happy when he approached me to do We Are One, the song We Are One, because it's something totally different than what I'm used to, the type of music that I'm used to. But I do like all types of music, especially since I've been here to learn about flamenco and the music and everything. So I'm very open when it comes to wanting to be a part of a different type of music, a different genre of music. And Toner invited me to do this, you know, and I'm very appreciative that I had the chance. And the music, you know, it's a conglomeration of jazz and soul and contemporary type music. You know, it's just a different feeling, and I like it. I enjoyed it. And we are again, like I said, we have another release coming out very soon, which is the mix of Ring My Bell. You know, I have a surprise. I guess I can, you know, I have a band, Spanish musicians that are going to be working with me in, starting in November, right? Correct? November. And I'm tickled about that, because the rhythm that I have experienced in Spanish music is amazing. I love it. I love the feel of it, and I'm looking forward to putting our music together with Spanish music, you know, funk and soul and jazz, just see what we can come up with. And I think that from what I've, the music that I've heard and everything, I think it's going to be a great music. You know, we're going to come up with some great music and great sounds.
Step back and set me free, 'cause you can love.